First opened in the millennium year of 2000, there's a look at Comerica Park here in Detroit. Tonight we wrap up this three-game series between the New York Yankees and the Detroit Tigers. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. Shane Green, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. What do you have for us on him, EK?
Well, guys, last year, ERA was not good. Skyrocketed all season long. He's hoping to post a much better year this time around.
Swing and a liner, but foul. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. Eric, these Tigers, as they begin play here tonight, they come in trying to rebound after a loss that snapped a modest three-game winning streak.
And that last loss was one of those games that you hate to lose. It really could have gone either way, but for our sake, I hope we get another close game like that here.
So now let's take a look at Joe Girardi's lineup for the visiting Yankees. What's this lineup got to do tonight to get a W on the road, Steve? This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. And with that, let's take a look at the defense for the Detroit Tigers. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, Matty, Anthony Ghost made a name for himself because of his defense. He has an absolute cannon for an arm, and he's fast enough to track anything down that's hit his way. Takes a lot.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Nolan Ryan is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. Eric, any thoughts?
Yeah, Matty, in his last start, he had a ton of strikeouts. He'll be looking to duplicate that effort here. Jose
Iglesias. And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Ref Snyder is there to make the catch, and it's a one-pitch out to start the home first. Into the box, Justin Upton. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. And as the Yankees get started here tonight, EK, been a fairly decent start to the year, 3-2 in their first five.
And after the loss in the opener of the series, that was a much-needed win yesterday. So they can look to win this series and take two out of three if they can just take care of business here.
With a moment now, let's give you a look at the Yankees' defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, the center fielder in this one, as good as anybody out there in the field. Has a lot of speed, can cover a lot of ground, and most importantly, he's very reliable.
Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Teixeira has got it, and the side is retired. The first baseman, Mark Teixeira, will come forward now. Back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off.
Mark Teixeira.
Pulled toward right center field. Goes is after it. One away.
Batting fifth.
Into the box now, Carlos Beltran, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. First pitch coming, here it is. And the first pitch to the 38-year-old veteran is in for a called strike, nothing in one.
That's a two-seam fastball right there. It looks to the hitter like it's going to be inside, and then it tails back to the inside corner of the plate.
Well, time to look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Dave Lawrence.
I think Lawrence is pretty consistent and respected for his strike zone. He doesn't seem to miss many pitches too often.
Upton going back, and this one is gone. A home run. A solo shot here for Carlos Beltran. Number 394 career, as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Batting six, third baseman.
Standing in now, Justin Turner. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. At home run, estimated at 401 feet. And he misses with it, 1-1. and he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Bases are empty, one man out. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Slapped hard the opposite way. And he tries to go to a knee to block it, but it's by him down the right field line. Didi Gregorius takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Oh, and they've got him picked off. And they will tag him out between first and second. Hit hard on the ground to second. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Yeah, really not a bad pitch when you look at it. This is at the knees with some movement. He just uses the center of the diamond and checks in here with a base hit.
From the stretch. Skied into straightaway right. Martinez has a beat on it, and that retires the side. Yankees are off and running early thanks to the soul. J.D. Martinez will stand in, and he wasn't much of a factor yesterday as he took an 0 for 4 in the loss.
You know, guys, we all know that those kind of games are going to happen in this sport. It's a tough game out there, no matter who you are. But the good ones are able to put that day behind you and go out and focus on the next game.
And he falls behind 0-2. Ryan into the windup. 0-2 pitch on its way. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Now in the box, Victor Martinez. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
And we all know he's a much better hitter from the other side.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Turner is over and he tucks it away for the second out.
Batting six, second baseman.
Ian Kinsler will stand in now. He homered in the ball game yesterday afternoon. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up at 1-1. Drilled to the right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole, and he will get him at first. Rob Refsnyder will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Martinez is over to his left as he snags this one for the first out of the inning.
Now batting, left fielder.
Brett Gardner will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game.
And he only saw a couple pitches, too. And that's great for the pitcher when you can get an easy leadoff out like that.
But this will hang up just enough as he takes it in stride in left center for the second out.
The center fielder.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and standing in the fine center fielder, Adam Jones. Hard liner toward short, but this will find the shortstop's glove for the third out of the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, but they're up 1-0. Jared Saltalamacchia will come forward to begin the inning. 7-8-9 to start the home third.
catcher. And they're still searching for a base runner. It's been six up, six down to start the game.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one. You like what you've seen from this guy so far?
I do. I like where he's putting the fastball, and I like the movement he's been getting on both his curveball and changeup. I think he'll do well.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. Nick Castellanos will stand in now. 0 for 4 in that day game yesterday.
Well, when you have a rough day at the plate, it's all about letting it go. You can't dwell on it for too long.
Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike.
Now that he's fully loose out there, you can see he's getting a little more zip on that fastball than he had coming out of the gate.
Throw on to Teixeira, two down. Anthony Gose will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Throw on to Teixeira is going to be in time, and with it, the inning is over. Down in order go the Tigers. It remains 1-0. Edgar Martinez will start things out here for the Pinstripers, to be followed by Mark Teixeira on deck.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat, because you know he has big-time power.
Line toward right center. A screaming base hit here, his first of the night.
Well, you got to start a streak somewhere, and he's well into this one now. A six-game hit streak with that base hit. He's swinging the bat pretty good right now.
And that's lifted the other way out to left. Upton's under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. So a runner at first with one out now. And here's the ever-dangerous Carlos Beltran. He's set. Here it comes. Hit high and deep out to left center field. Ghost going back, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
Now batting.
Justin Turner is the batter. Got a base hit in his first trip.
Yeah, and just another simple single to the outfield here would be big for these guys. It could score, too.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Not his best effort that time. It's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Catch is made here in right, and here comes the runner from third. A block at the plate, and he's out trying to score. It's a double play, and the inning is over. One. Jose Iglesias will stand in to begin their half of the fourth, with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
And still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
And he takes a cold strike, 0-1. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Now he's just running right through these guys. Absolutely worn him down.
Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Ryan's ready. Here's the 0-2. Chop foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. The 0-2 delivery. And oh, strike three called on a fastball that looked inside from here, but that's out number one.
Not even the best players are immune to a bad call from time to time. And to me, that's not a strike. And I think to him, that's not a strike either. But hey, guy in blue, it's strike three, and he's the only one that counts.
Here's Justin Upton now, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. No runs, no hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the Tigers. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
I remember Justin Upton made his major league debut for the Arizona Diamondbacks at the tender age of 19. That's a pretty rare occurrence, but the moment never seemed too big for him.
Out in front of that one. May have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact. Yeah, it didn't take Justin long to make an impression in the big leagues either.
Nope. He was up in the majors for only 2 days before he hit his first major league home run.
And the Tigers are into the hit column now. That's their first hit of the contest. Miguel Cabrera will stand in here, the reigning batting champion in the American League. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1. Good cut that time by Cabrera, but he couldn't come up with it. It's 0-2.
You can tell he's still frustrated after that first called strike. It's still on his mind.
A pause and the 0-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two. J.D. Martinez will stand in. He took home a Silver Slugger Award for American League outfielders a year ago. And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Didi Gregorius heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Shortstop.
First offering on its way.
Gregorius.
92 splits the plate and it's strike one. Hit hard to short. Iglesias is up with it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting.
Stepping in, Gary Sanchez. He flew out in his last at bat. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location right on the knees.
One run, five hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
Well, you know, when you're behind in a count like this, it's all about changing your approach at the plate. You got to shorten up a little bit and just look to put the ball in play.
And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth. Now Rob Refsnyder is at the plate now, flied out in his first at bat. Flipped out the other way towards short. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out. Brett Gardner will try things again. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips.
Yeah, he got solid contact on that line out, but it just didn't work out. In this game, you have to trust your approach. Eventually, it's going to pay off.
Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon. Adam Jones stands in trying to make it three straight two-out hits. He's got a runner in scoring position at second.
And you know how good hitting can prove contagious in an inning. Let's see if he can keep it rolling.
And here's a fastball called for strike one. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And Jones takes this one for a ball, 1-1.
And even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Goes is under it. And that's the third out. Yanks strand a pair. They lead it 1-0. Victor Martinez will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Youngsters 14 and under and their parents are invited.
Ryan has his target. First pitch on the way. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front. A ball and a strike.
And that right there, that's why these guys only have one hit. He's had him chasing its shadows this entire ballgame.
Turner onto the grass. One down. A little bit over halfway home tonight. Bottom of the fifth as we get a look at our line score to this point. And boy, just one hit for these guys, and they have not swung the bats well. That's putting it mildly. Ian Kinsler is next as he finds himself behind 0-1. Scorch to third. Turner's got it. Throw on to first. Takes care of Kinsler here for out number two.
Up next for the Tigers,
Jared Saltalamacchia is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Yeah, one pitch away now from getting through five shutout innings. And
hot shot to first base and a great play to end the inning. We are in Motown, but I don't think we'll be seeing any of these people dancing in a soul review tonight. We've got more on this Sunday night after this. Edgar Martinez will dig in. 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a liner. Foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. And, oh, he definitely broke the plane there as he went after the pitch inside, and it's strike two. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
Squared that one up just a little late. Liner towards second. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
The first baseman, number 25, Mark Teixeira.
Mark Teixeira will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far.
Yeah, and he just needs to make a small adjustment and stay through the middle of the ball. Think about hitting the line drive right back up the middle.
Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. Oh, good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. One out, nobody on. Left field and deep. Upton ranging back, but he won't get there. It falls in. Carlos Beltran will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. Sliced hard on the ground to Iglesias for one. On to Cabrera at first. It's a twin killing and the side is Nick Castellanos will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first five innings have not been particularly kind to them.
Yeah, and I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first five innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Seems like it's been a fairly consistent pattern. Hard stuff early, soft stuff late. But these guys don't seem to have caught on yet.
It's a pretty standard operating procedure, too. But they just look lost.
Anthony Gosch is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Got him out on his front foot there as it swung on and missed for strike one.
Yeah, and he's really getting over the top of that curveball.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
And at least he's taken a few pitches here. You know, that's more than the rest of these guys can say.
Fastball is looked at for strike two. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ball game.
Two straight strikeouts here to start out the inning, but that's eight for him now in the ball game. These guys have really had a hard time figuring him out.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Very weakly on the ground. Throw on to Teixeira to take care of him, and that ends the inning. Up three down for Detroit. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Justin Turner will come forward now to begin the seventh inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
And that's what happens when you get two starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and a very even game through six innings.
Hit to third, taken in by Castellanos. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Now batting.
And, you know, he really doesn't have to throw that changeup all that much for it to be an effective pitch. And you can see what his breakdown is so far.
Into the seats, 0-1. You know, I think Didi Gregorius has one of the most interesting backgrounds of anybody in the big leagues. Born in Amsterdam, his dad played professionally in Europe, and his mom was a star softball player. And not only that, his brother played professionally in the Italian Baseball League. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And the count will be full. Bases are empty, one man out. Lifted the other way out to left center. After it is goes. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Gary Sanchez will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Swing and a little blooper to center. Ghost is there. And that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. But they're on. Justin Upton steps into the box as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the seventh.
Well, this has been a great game so far, and they're only down by one. So getting this leadoff guy on would be huge for them.
High in the air out to center field. Jones is under it. And that's the first out of the inning. Miguel Cabrera will come forward now. He's popped out and struck out in his first two plate appearances. Ryan gets the sign. Here's the first pitch. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
And if they can get him here with a little luck, they may not have to face him again.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out.
The right fielder, number 28,
J.D. Martinez, will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Well, we've been talking about it a lot, but this offense is just getting shut down right now. And we've seen some really fantastic pitching in this one.
Hard hit ball to second. That's through, and he's got his first base hit. He's 1-for-3.
Yeah, and guys, there's a look at his line through the first few innings. Pretty dominant so far. Just the second hit he's allowed tonight, and the first one didn't wind up hurting him at all. So we'll see if he can get out of this inning as well.
Victor Martinez is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
Now you've got the tying run over at first. Two away. He's going to be looking to try and find a gap right here and bring that guy all the way around to score.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. Hot shot down the line. Now the 0-2 pitch. Hit out towards second. Reined in. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Alex Wilson will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Alex Wilson.
Rob Refsnyder will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. Had him reach in that time. It's strike one. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two. Do you even bother with anything else here?
No, I sure wouldn't. As a hitter, you're thinking, look for fastball, adjust for an off-speed pitch. And so far in this at-bat, he hasn't made any adjustments.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Upton moves over. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Brett Gardner gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now a ball hit high and deep, heading toward the corner in left. And that'll slice just foul at the last moment. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. One out, nobody on. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
Oh, and he just fans on it out there at second as it gets right by him.
Yeah, and plenty of hits here so far, but not a lot to show for it in the run column. Maybe this can help turn that around as they get a man on here with just one away.
And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Now a swing and a fly ball. Martinez on the move, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
The batter, designated hitter.
Digging in now, Edgar Martinez. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
And Matt, with the double play in order, they'll obviously be looking to induce another ground ball out of him right here.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. Runners are at the corners with one man out. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Looking to keep this a one-run game. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And nope, this one falls, so he'll get another shot. Has to be thinking strikeout here. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Mark Teixeira steps in for a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth.
Yeah, this is a huge moment in this ballgame, Matt. I mean, you might be looking at this at-bat when it's all over as one of the turning points in this game.
Throw on to first, and the Yankee threat goes by the boards as the Yanks strand a pair. But they lead it 1-0.
Leading off for the Tigers, number five.
Ian Kinsler will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. and a swing and a miss at a pitch well off the plate. It's strike one. Well, the guy you see right there has been terrific. But will they let him work these final two innings?
Well, I think the pitch count is in his favor. Everybody pays a lot of attention to that. So barring a huge spike right here in the eighth, I don't see any reason why he can't get these final six outs.
And that misses 2-2.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
There to take it is Beltran, and that's out number one.
Now batting, catcher
Jared Saltalamacchia will dig in now. He struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. And that's a called strike at the letters. Though that looked high from here, it's 0-2 now.
And this isn't the first guy that's been frozen by that pitch tonight. He's had a lot of guys shaking their heads so far.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Hit in the air to left field. Gardner is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
The third baseman, number nine.
Nick Castellanos will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Swing and a miss. Blew it right by him at 96. It's a ball and a strike.
And even though that is a strike, man, that thing is coming in so hard, it's almost impossible to get a level swing off. You're better off taking it and waiting for something you can handle a little better.
Chop foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Down in order go the Tigers. They're down 1-0. We're set for what's left of this one from Detroit as we welcome you back to Major League Baseball on the show. Bobby Parnell. Come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. Carlos Beltran stands in as he looks at a called strike. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line in left. Upton is there, one quick out to start inning number nine.
Now batting, third baseman.
Justin Turner will step in, a ground out victim his last time. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. Oh, look at Castellanos. Got him.
Woo, no problem.
Now batting, shortstop.
Didi Gregorius will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. And now this will head for the 345 sign as it's off the wall. And he will stroll in there standing with a two-out double.
Now batting.
Pretty fortunate he was able to keep this ball fair. This is pretty close down the line. You see it winding up, one hopping the wall down there, and that allows him to cruise into second with two bases.
Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Anthony Gose will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far.
Anthony.
Lifted the other way to left center. Gardner is there. One out. Jose Iglesias will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far. And that's in there for strike one.
Well, this pitching staff has done a pretty darn good job against him in this series.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Jones on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Justin Upton. Stand in now is their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Now this is up and in, and I don't think he likes that location much. It's ball one. That's by him for strike one. And that's cut on and missed. So now the Tigers find themselves down to their last strike. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Yeah, just two hits were all they could muster off of him. He was in complete control from the start of this game, and he finished it off in style, too.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. And, guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, definitely no debate as far as I'm concerned. He was really in complete control the whole way through. Only really got into trouble a few times, and he winds up with a complete game shutout.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian.
Welcome to your Saturday edition of Inside the Show. I'm Justin Allegri. Starting in the AL East, the Yankees sent three balls into the seats as they took down the visiting Mariners 9-5. The win was their sixth straight as a team. In other Yankees news, starting pitcher CC Sabathia is currently listed as day-to-day. He's dealing with an abdominal strain. The Toronto Blue Jays grabbed 13 hits in the game as they took down the Red Sox on the road 6-1. The Rays cracked 14 hits overall as they took down the Chi Sox in front of a home crowd 9-4.
Afternoon baseball now on the show as you get a look at Yankee Stadium here in New York. Today it's the second of this three-game series between the Seattle Mariners and the New York Yankees. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. Nolan Ryan gets the ball for the Yankees in this one. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, you're watching one of the best to ever take the mound. Over 300 career wins. Well, what he's done in his career has been absolutely spectacular. And he's still going strong. I can't wait to watch him in this one.
Leonis Martin makes his way to the plate, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Center fielder, number 12.
High and deep to right center field. Jones going back, still going back. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. A moment now to give you a look at the Mariners' starting lineup. Steve, what do they have to do to take down a very hot team here on the road?
Well, I think you need to take advantage of balls up in the zone, and you could probably say that almost every day, but this is a great hitter's park. You get something to drive, they end up in the seats here.
And he falls behind 0-2. A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
The designated hitter, Nelson Cruz.
Nelson Cruz is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
Well, that's a good thing that pitch was above the strike zone because a few inches lower, and that ball's right in his wheelhouse.
That's in there on the outer half, 1-2 now.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Felix Hernandez is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Mariners. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, he's had a real nice career. Over 2,000 strikeouts. A lot of swing and misses. A lot of deceiving stuff. I expect to see more of the same in this one.
Here comes Brett Gardner now as he'll lead things off in the home first.
Leading off for the Yankees, left fielder Brett Gardner.
Bat explodes as this is popped up. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down. With that, it's time to check out the starting lineup for the hometown Yankees. Thoughts, EK? Anyone stand out?
Well, you still got to look out for Carlos Beltran these days. He hasn't been missing much lately, hitting 3 home runs over the last 10 ballgames. Not an eye-popping statistic, but still a good indication that he's been in a groove at the plate.
Mark Teixeira takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Hernandez comes set. Here's the 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. EK, you look at the M's entering play here this afternoon. They were losers last time out, but still in a decent groove as they'd won 4 of 5 prior to that.
Yeah, and they dropped the opener of the series and of the road trip last time out. I thought they came out a little flat, but still plenty of time to turn that around, though.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Ready on 1-2. Changeup, and that fades down and away, 2-2.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Swing and a little tapper. That goes foul, so he stays alive with 2 strikes.
This is turning into a great battle at the plate.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And another foul ball. Keeps fighting him off. The 8th pitch of the at-bat coming up. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Oh, and this just jumps off the bat here as this is to deep straightaway right field, and you can pretty much forget about this one. That is a long home run. It's a 2-run home run for Mark Teixeira, the 396th of his career. And this is now a 2-0 lead for the Yankees.
That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Here's Carlos Beltran.
Right fielder, Carlos.
As he's swinging first pitch and sends a line drive out to left center. And Beltran's got himself extra bases as this finds the gap. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Well, you can say one thing for sure. They are swinging it like they mean it. That's three hits already in the first inning, and this one goes for two bases. They're having no trouble at all seeing this guy so far.
Swing and a liner. Foul. One out and a runner on second base. And this is hit in the air over toward the left field line. And that's a fair ball. The throw home. And he is safe at the plate. And the lead is now 3-0.
Well, you talk about being locked in at the plate right now. That is 10 straight games with a base hit now. And it's going to be a lot of fun to see how long he can keep this thing going.
Line toward right center. In there, a base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single. Gary Sanchez will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view. This is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Would you say he's not really finishing his pitches at this point?
That's a good way to put it. It looks like he's aiming a little too much, and that's not working for him.
Fastball at 94 miles an hour, and it's 1-1.
Oh, and that's a good fastball right there. He might have been thinking about protecting against that sinker.
Slap hard the opposite way. Gutierrez has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And with that, let's take a look at how the Mariners will set up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, Kyle Seager over at third base, one of the best all-around third basemen in the game. Remember, he was an all-star in 2014. Also,
well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. But they strike for three. Adam Lind will get his first shot here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. Second inning starts with a fastball that misses. It's 1-0.
Well, you got to figure that this guy's going to come out here free and easy here in the second. He's got a three-run cushion already. No reason not to come right after these guys.
Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Second baseman.
Robinson Cano will stand in with an even 300 average here in the month of April. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. That evens it up, 1-1. I had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2. Breaking ball misses the corner. Two balls and two strikes.
That's a pitch that you got to stay on top of, or else it'll take off on you just like that one did.
Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second.
Batting six.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and digging in is the right fielder, Franklin Gutierrez. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Yeah, and that's the swing of a guy hoping for a first-pitch curveball right there. If he gets it, he hammers it. If not, he's about 3 feet too late.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. Ref Snyder is up with it. Throw on to Teixeira is going to be in time, and with it, the inning is over. So they go quietly. Rob Ref Snyder will stride in now. Two hits for him, including a home run in last night's contest.
Yeah, that was a good one for him, and he needed it because, as you can see, his batting average on the year ain't pretty.
And a feeble swing that time. It's 0-1. Think you'll see another one of those before this at-bat's through?
After that swing, I think you can just about take that to the bank.
And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning. Brett Gardner in now, popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fastball. That top hand kind of dragged through the zone, which caused the bat head to drop a little bit.
First offering on its way. Out in front of it, strike one. Nobody out, runner on first. And low, it's a ball and a strike. Smoked on the ground, left side. That's through for a base hit, and he's one for two now.
Well, you talk about being comfortable at the plate. That's the way he's feeling it right now. Nine straight games with that base hit now.
Edgar Martinez strides in after getting a base hit and later scoring the first time around.
And I think we mentioned it already, but that extended his hitting streak. Swinging a hot bat right now.
And that's in there. Base hit. But this is well up the line, and he's safe at home plate.
Now the pitching coach is going to come in and have a word with him. And in the second inning, once he makes sure he's okay physically, he'll be saying, hey, look, let's put all that's just happened behind us and focus on the task at hand.
Well, now the Mariners get some action in the bullpen as a left-hander's begun to get loose. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Into the seats, 0-1. The 0-1 delivery. Oh, and he gets a hold of this one as it's in the air to deep left. Does he have another one? He does. It's another home run. A three-run home run for Mark Teixeira. Number 397 for him now as he draws closer to 400 as this lead swells to 7-0.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game, and it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one, so he's definitely locked in.
Up next for the
Here's
game.
Carlos Beltran.
Right fielder.
As he goes after the first pitch and lines one out toward right center. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. The relay. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. Wade Miley is going to come on now here in just the second inning, so he'll likely be asked to work a few innings here.
Now pitching for Seattle.
Adam Jones will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be doing so with the runner in scoring position and still nobody out. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Shot toward second. But there is the second baseman, Cano, for the first down.
Now batting.
Stepping in, Justin Turner. He reached on a single in his first try.
And they take another single right here, too, no doubt. Runner in scoring position, so any ball into the outfield probably gets him home.
Skied into straightaway right. Gutierrez is back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone. Gary Sanchez stands in for the second time. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at-bat.
And, Matt, you know what? It's always a little frustrating when you square one up, you hit a solid live drive somewhere, and all you get to show for it is a nice little jog right back to the dugout. That can get in your head a little bit after a while.
Throw in time, and they stop the bleeding as the side is retired. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. We've played two. It's the Yankees 7 and the Mariners nothing. A look there at the most famous urban park in the United States, Central Park, set to go again here from Yankee Stadium. Nori Aoki will lead things off here with his guys down 7 in the early going. Steve Lyons, how do you come back from a deficit like that?
Well, I think slowly. I mean, yeah, ideally a 10-run inning would be great, but you've got time on your side.
You don't need to try to get it all back at once. Just peck away. A couple runs here, a couple runs there. Get yourself into slam range. That's four runs down.
Ryan's ready. Here's the first pitch. Now a fastball to start the third. That misses. It's ball one. You like what you've seen from this guy so far?
I do. I like where he's putting the fastball, and I like the movement he's been getting on both his curveball and changeup. I think he'll do well.
Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
And this is why, as a hitter, working the count in your favor is so important. I mean, here, this is probably a ball, but you can't risk taking this pitch on one and two and hope that you get the benefit of the umpire's call. You pretty much have to swing at it, even though you probably wouldn't have been able to do much with it in the first place.
And he'll put it away now without much of a problem. Two gone now here in the third. Mike Zunino will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Oh, and he's finding his groove out there now. It's 0-2.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing. And
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Didi Gregorius digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
Well, guys, they jumped out to that big lead early on in this game, but you really can't get comfortable. You have to keep putting pressure on.
Ground ball sent back up the middle, and this is bobbled now by Cano. And some problems defensively as they allow him to reach first safely.
Now batting. Second baseman.
Into the box, Rob Refsnyder. He singled his last time up. First delivery to him on the way. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one. The early hit total, about what you'd expect in a score line such as this. Got him to swing at a pitch below the knees, 1-1.
Yeah, just really jumping out at that last pitch. He had him thinking fastball, maybe even slider.
And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Missed third inning starting out about as poorly as the second inning did.
Hit sharply on the ground to the left. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. Brett Gardner will stride in. Popped out and singled in his two trips.
Yeah, and he made just a little adjustment last time coming off of that pop-up the first time around, and he got himself a base knock. That's what the good ones do.
Hard hit toward the hole. And that's through into left, a base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. Edgar Martinez will get a shot here in a bases-loaded situation, and you'd have to say they've got the right man for the job up here.
Yeah, the team leader in RBIs. He's got a shot to push that lead out even further if he could come through here.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Martin is under it. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score. Mark Teixeira will stand in now with five RBIs to his credit already and a chance to add on some more.
And you know, Matt, the way he's attacked the baseball so far, why stop now?
Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's going to be sleeping well tonight, is it?
Swung on and missed by Teixeira, and they've got him right where they want him now, 0-2.
Oh, and you can tell by these first couple swings, he's not just looking to poke one through the right side of the infield. He's looking to put something into orbit.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Chop foul at the plate and we'll do it again. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And Teixeira swings and misses as he set down on strikes for out number two. Carlos Beltran stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still early.
And that's through into center field. Base hit around third and being waved on home. The run scores from second make it 9-0.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see him. He was right on that one.
First pitch coming. Here it is. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Coming in is Martin. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So it's two runs on four base hits. No errors and a couple of men left on. Leonis Martin will stand in to begin their half of the fourth with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
And still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
And he misses with it, 1-1. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
Yeah, And it's hard to look for a changeup there, especially when a guy's got a good live fastball.
And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away. Kyle Seager is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch. Something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. Ryan into the windup. 2-1 on its way. Oh, and a big swing there by Seager as he gets a hold of one high and deep out to right field. Oh, and that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2. Following next is... Hang on, this is hit deep into right center. This looks to have enough, and it does. A home run. A solo home run here for Kyle Seager. And they're now on the board, though still well behind. So that long ball has taken him one away from the century mark in home runs for his career. Not a major milestone, but a pretty impressive number nonetheless.
Yeah, good for him. He's really shown some solid power so far in his career. And he's about to reach a milestone that quite a few major league hitters never reach.
Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. Trying to strike him out for the second time. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time. Out number two. Settling in now, Adam Lind. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
Well, anytime you throw a first pitch strike to less than 50% of the hitters you're facing, you're looking for trouble, but not so in this game. We're in the middle innings here, and he's still pitching well.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Gardner's after it. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Mariners get one on this swing by Kyle Seager. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Yankees. Justin Turner is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Third baseman.
Here comes the first pitch.
Justin Turner.
Smoke toward third. There is Seager. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away.
Catcher.
Gary Sanchez will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips.
He seems to be seeing the ball okay, though, making some decent contact so far.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Under it now is Gutierrez, and he'll take it for out number two.
Now batting.
Didi Gregorius steps in, working on a one-for-two game so far. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And that's lifted the other way out to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, but they still hold a commanding 9-1 lead. Robinson Cano heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting, right fielder.
Franklin Gutierrez stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
Ryan has his target, looking for the strikeout here on 0-2. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth. stepping in and ready for another shot, Nori Aoki. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0.
That one's going to find the seats, strike one. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Hit in the air out to straightaway left. Gardner is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Rob Refsnyder comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Chopped weakly to the left. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Up next for the Yankees,
Brett Gardner digs in, coming off a single in his last at bat. Grounded up the first baseline. Lind has it, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Now batting,
Edgar Martinez will stand in. He drove in a run with a sack fly his last time. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. And a fastball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here. 2-0.
3-0 now.
I think at this point, a two-out walk isn't the worst thing in the world. You'd like to avoid it if you can, but this can be a dangerous spot if you just groove one.
And he gets the call there, 3-1. In the air to center field and deep back is the center fielder. Back he goes, but this is going to be a home run. So it's a solo shot to dead center. Home run number 5 on the year as they've pushed this lead up to 9 now.
I tell you, that's the perfect storm there. A power pitcher on the mound throwing a hard fastball to a power hitter at the plate. He takes a big swing and squares it perfectly. I mean, that's as long a home run as you're going to see.
Grounded back up the middle. Backhanded. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Yanks able to add on one more via the solo home run. 5 innings complete, and this is now a 10-1 ball game. Ketel Marte will come in now to start things out here in their half of the sixth as they look for a reversal of fortunes here. The first 5 innings have not been particularly kind to them.
And I think that's putting it mildly. Just one hit in these first 5 innings, they're going to need to do a better job of finding good pitches to hit. But that fellow on the mound has not made it easy on him, and that's for sure.
Well, this is certainly not good here. He's really holding on to his arm, and I think it appears to be fairly serious. Pretty sure we're not going to see him in action for a while, unfortunately. Ivan Nova will be summoned now to take over following the injury.
Number 47, Ivan Nova.
Ketel Marte will get things going here in the Mariners' sixth as he'll step in to lead off the inning. And guys, little doubt that the big bat here tonight belonged to this gentleman right here, Mark Teixeira. What a performance he turned in. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he delivered more than once with runners in scoring position. Finished with five RBIs. That was more than enough to lead.
Happy Friday, baseball fans. Welcome to Inside the Show. Starting in the AL East, the A's combined for 10 hits as a team as they took down the Yankees in the Bronx 4-0. Looking at the standings, the Yankees are in first place in the AL East. The A's sit in fourth place in the American League West. The Rays put together 10 hits total as they took down the Red Sox on the road 3-2. At the moment, the Red Sox sit in last place in the American League East Division. The Rays sit in fourth place in the American League East Division. The Blue Jays beat the O's in Baltimore 4-3. Right now, the Orioles are in second place in the AL East. The Blue Jays sit in third place in the American League East Division. The Chicago White Sox knocked out 10 hits as a team as they defeated the visiting Angels 3-1. As of today, the White Sox sit in last place in the American League Central Division. The Angels are in third place in the AL West. Carlos Santana plated 3 runs on the day, leading the Tribe over the Mariners 9-5. Looking at the standings, the Indians are in third place in the AL Central. The Mariners sit in second place in the American League West. The Detroit Tigers cracked 14 hits overall as they beat the Royals in Kauffman Stadium 8-3. Heading into today, the Royals sit in second place in the AL Central Division. The Tigers are sitting atop the AL Central. The Houston Astros finished off a 3-game sweep as they grabbed the win over the Rangers in Arlington 5-1. Right now, the Rangers are in last place in the AL West. The Astros sit in first place in the American League West Division. The Dodgers brought out the brooms in a 3-game sweep as they beat the Braves in Atlanta 7-1. At the moment, the Braves are in third place in the NL East. The Dodgers sit in first place in the National League West Division. The Nationals cracked 16 hits on the day as they took down the Fish in Miami 3-2. As of today, the Marlins are in fourth place in the NL East. The Nationals sit in second place in the National League East Division. The Chicago Cubs combined for 10 hits as a team as they got past the Reds in Cincinnati 5-2. Looking at the standings, the Reds are in fourth place in the NL Central. The Cubs are atop the NL Central. Alex Rodriguez plated 5 on the day with 2 big flies, helping lead the Twins over Milwaukee 7-4. He extended his hitting streak to a modest 6 straight games. Right now, the Brewers sit in last place in the National League Central Division. The Twins are in fourth place in the AL Central. The Pirates allowed 5 hits in the game as they grabbed a victory over the Padres at Petco Park 4-2. At the moment, the Padres sit in fourth place in the National League West. The Pirates sit in third place in the National League Central Division. Johnny Cueto finished the complete game in his win as the Giants beat the Diamondbacks 3-1. Heading into today, the Giants sit in second place in the National League West Division. The Diamondbacks sit in last place in the National League West Division. That's all for today's show. See you back here tomorrow. Have a great day.
Now from the home of the Rangers, there's a good look at Globe Life Park here in Arlington. Tonight we wrap up this three-game series between the New York Yankees and the Texas Rangers. Stay tuned for Rangers baseball next. Martin Perez gets the starting assignment for the Rangers in this one. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, he's having a very nice season so far. You look at that ERA in the low twos. Looking to continue that trend here in this one.
Behind on that one. Now behind in the count, 0-1.
7-0-7.
The windup and the 0-1. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut. And, Eric, you take a look at these Rangers entering play here tonight. They come in riding a five-game winning streak, and they've really got things clicking.
Yeah, but they've got a tough assignment on the mound here tonight, so they're going to have their hands full. But the way they've been playing, I get the sense that no one in that dugout is too concerned.
High in the air out to center field. Stubbs on the move. He's got it, and there are two down now. With a moment now, let's take a look at how the Rangers will align defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, defensively, they have the lowest fielding percentage in the majors. Not a lot of fun when you're
out of here. She was a wall scraper, but it counts just the same. A home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Eighth home run on the season for him as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead. Oh, he looks like he's swinging a garden hose out there as this is cut on and missed for strike one. Swung on and missed by Teixeira, and they've got him right where they want him now, 0-2.
But this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Throw on to fielders in time, and with that, the side is retired. Yankees are off and running early thanks to the solo home run. On to the bottom of the first here in Arlington. It's now 1-0 New York. Nolan Ryan is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. What's your take on him, EK?
Well, guys, you're watching one of the best to ever take the mound. Over 300 career wins. But what he's done in his career has been absolutely spectacular. And he's still going strong. I can't wait to watch him in this one.
And he'll get there as he starts the home first with a leadoff triple. Rougned Odor will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Ryan sets. Here's the 0-1. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. And as the Yankees get started here tonight, EK, they've been on the skids recently, losers in seven of their last nine ball games.
And the silver lining to that is that they do have their ace going here tonight. He's what folks used to call the stopper.
And the run will score on the sacrifice fly as that'll square things at 1-1. Adrian Beltre will stand in. Couple of hits in that ball game last night. That ball comes in and gets him.
Yeah, you know, as a pitcher, sometimes you can just say, hey, that one got away from me. It slipped. But I think that one would be a tough claim to make. This one definitely doesn't pass the eye test for me. I'm a little bit surprised that the home plate umpire is letting that thing go.
And it's quickly 0-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Now time now to look at Jeff Banister's Rangers lineup card in this one. What do you think they need to do to keep this winning streak rolling, Steve?
Well, I think you need to take advantage of balls up in the zone, and you could probably say that almost every day, but this is a great hitter's park. You get something to drive, they end up in the seats here.
And a strike to even the count, 1-1. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. And good take that time on a low breaking ball. 2-2 now.
Yeah, and on 1-2, when you know the guy at the plate.
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. Carlos Beltran will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Here's the first pitch to him. chopped foul right at home plate at strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a liner. Foul. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. He'll throw down to first, one away.
Batting six.
Adam Jones comes to the plate looking to flip the script. His bat has gone ice cold over the last eight or so ball games. Chop foul right at home plate. Bases are empty, one man out. Chopped weakly to the left. Beltre is right there. Throw on to fielder for out number two.
Batting seven.
Didi Gregorius will stand in. He comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game.
Yeah, not really a great performance for him yesterday, but that's just part of this ball game. You have to know that those rough.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Shin-Soo Chu will stride in now. Two hits for him, including a home run in last night's contest.
Well, he's had seven RBIs in his last 10 games, so he is producing runs, and he had another good one yesterday.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And that's where you're going to have to be with that fastball. Like a lot of power guys, this guy is a pull hitter, so he has a lot of trouble getting out in front of that hard stuff. Kind of comes around that pitch when it's up and away like that.
Ian Desmond is the batter now as he looks at a ball 1-0. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard. Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker.
Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
Well, the strikeouts sure come in bunches for this guy. Remember, he had 10 of them in his last start, and he's well on his way to maybe even matching that number in this game.
Here's Drew Stubbs now. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He'll enter play with an average of 311. Two home runs and seven driven in. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Wellington Castillo will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Here comes the 2-0 pitch. Left a change out there for him, but he missed it 2-1.
Boy, and a great 2-0 pitch there. Got him thinking fastball. And this looked like a fastball out of his hand, but it turns out to be a real effective changeup instead.
Desmond is camped under this one, and he puts it away for the first down.
Batting ninth.
Rob Refsnyder will dig in now. Rob off to a slow start, as you see there, just barely over the 200 mark here in April. Lined back over second, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Now batting,
Brett Gardner will dig in for a second time, a strikeout victim opening up the ball game.
And remember, they got him on a fastball, so I got to figure they're going to attack him the exact same way.
This is pulled into right. Chu is there. Two down.
Yeah, you really can't take anything for granted out there when you're playing in the rain. You got to worry about your footing. You got to worry about raindrops getting in your eyes. You got to make sure you're in the right position. But in the end, he is right there to make the play.
Grounded to short. Andres fields it cleanly. Here's a flip to Odor covering, and the inning is over. One left for the Robinson Chirinos will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so against a guy who's definitely in a groove out there.
Yeah, he struck out the side his last time through, and they've got to do something to get this guy out of the role that he's been on.
And he gets him to swing through that one. He's in control 0-2.
Boy, he was so far behind that first pitch that he overadjusted and was so far ahead of this one.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
A shortstop, number one, Elvis Andrews.
Elvis Andrews will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up on that inside corner, or this guy will bury you.
And this will be hauled in by Beltran for out number two.
Second baseman.
In now, Rougned Odor earned himself an RBI with a sac fly his last time at the plate. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
And if he can get himself into a fastball.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is smoked to right, and I don't think this one's coming back. No chance. It's gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. And the Rangers move ahead. It's now 2-1. Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre.
The third baseman.
Nope. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
And after getting hit in his first at-bat, he's got to be saying, look, enough with the inside pitches already.
A strike, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, I don't think you want to come in throwing a lot of high changeups. That's a pitch he's going to have to get lower in the strike zone.
Fastball is looked at for strike two. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Jones on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Edgar Martinez is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2.
And this has been a common problem for all of these guys. They just can't lay off that pitch down and away.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And here's the dangerous Mark Teixeira.
Mark Teixeira.
Swing, and he puts a charge into this one, high and deep, and you can't forget about it. This ball is gone. Mark Teixeira has just cracked career home run number 398, putting him on the verge of entering a fairly exclusive group, the 400 Home Run Club.
And you know, Matt, even in my dream career, I didn't hit close to 400 home runs. It's really a remarkable milestone, so we're definitely going to be watching his at-bats as he continues to approach it.
Here's Carlos Beltran as he'll take a look at ball one. That previous home run, believed to be in the neighborhood of 430 feet. On the ground to third. Throw on to fielder for out number two.
Now batting.
So two are gone now in the Yankee half of the fourth. And standing in the fine center fielder, Adam Jones. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Stubbs moves over. And that's the third out. Mitch Moreland is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Designated hitter.
And he sends one deep down the right field line. Beltran is back, and he reaches up to put it away for a long out number one.
First baseman number 84.
Digging in to try it again, Prince Fielder. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
The right fielder,
you know,
17.
It seems like every time we check these out and show motion, it always looks like the bat breaks the plane. Look here, sure enough, I don't think he holds up in time. Looked to me like that was the right call.
Yeah. Shin-Soo Chu is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Here's a swing, and oh, man! Way out of here! A solo shot here to straightaway right field, and the Rangers have taken the lead. It's now 3-2. Standing in now, Ian Desmond.
Number 20.
They're still weighed out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one.
Boy, he goes right back to that same pitch that he just gave up a home run on. Put it in another dangerous look.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Rangers pick up a run here on the solo home run. We played four. It's now a 3-2 Ranger lead. Leading off the inning, Didi Gregorius, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Set to deliver the 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. A lot of balls down in the zone in the last inning or so.
And I think that's in response to getting bit by those two home run balls. He might be a little leery of challenging guys right now, and I don't blame him. Keep it down there.
Number 13.
At the plate, Wellington Castillo. He flew out in his last at-bat. Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. This gets foul. It's 0-1. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. Hits it high and deep out to center field. Stubbs racing back. Gone! So it's a solo shot to dead center, and with it, the Yankees have tied this one at three.
And this is where these guys can be so dangerous. They've got power all throughout the lineup. When the number eight hitter's taking you deep, you know there's no easy outs.
Stepping in now, Rob Refsnyder. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Well, the Yankees, with their three home runs now, still have a ways to go to match their record for a single game. Twice in their history, they've hit eight of them, most recently in 2007. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Brett Gardner will dig in now and struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats.
Yeah, he hit that ball pretty hard on the lineout. He just couldn't get it to fall for him.
He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. The 0-1 delivery. And he falls behind 0-2. Trying to strike him out for the second time. And he chased it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Drew Stubbs comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Center fielder, Drew.
In there, strike one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
And he won't offer at that. Too high. 1-2. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Now batting, catcher, Robinson.
Robinson Chirinos is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one.
This is where a guy who's been very aggressive around the plate may start thinking about being a little more fine later on in the game. When these guys start thinking, hey, you know what? I'm just going to go up there and jump on the first pitch. You don't even have to throw him something good to hit.
And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ballgame.
Elvis Andrews.
Out in front of it, strike one. And he lays off for ball one. Three runs, three hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Beltran moving to his left, and that ends the inning. Both teams battling the elements thus far, but we've got a tight game through five. We'll return to Texas in just a moment. Justin Turner steps in here to lead off the sixth as the rain continues to fall here. Now the Rangers get a reliever up and throwing in the bullpen as a right-hander's begun to warm up out there. He goes the other way as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Chu is under it to put it away, and it's one pitch, one out to kick off the sixth. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Good zip on that one as he just throws it by him for strike one. One out, nobody on. And he comes up empty there on a pitch in the dirt and falls behind now one and two.
Nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Oh, and he turns another one around here. And his fine ball game will continue. Give him another home run. So a solo shot here to left center field. His second of the game as they take the lead 4-3.
Yeah. Make it four home runs as a team now after that last one, and this guy's led the way with two of those four. I tell you, I wouldn't give this guy anything to hit next time around. He's as locked in as you can get.
Bounced weakly near the plate, but that one rolls foul. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Slow little grounder left side. A barehanded effort by Beltre. It's there and he's out.
Wow, made it look easy.
Right fielder.
Carlos Beltran will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. First pitch curveball runs in a bit too tight. It's ball one. Hit hard on the ground to second. Odor has it. Throw to fielder at first. He'll take care of him, and that'll be that. Rougned Odor will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
And this rain is intensifying now. This is as hard as it's come down all night.
Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number nine in the ball game. Adrian Beltre will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Beltre.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher, but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
Three runs, three hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. Hot shot to third. Turner has it. Throw to first will be in time to retire Beltre, and there's out number two.
Now batting, a designated hitter.
Mitch Moreland will stand in now. He struck out and flied out, 0 for 2 thus far. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Jones is under it. And the inning is over. Rangers set down in order. Still down a run. It's Tom Wilhelmsson is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven. Adam Jones will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And this is taken outside for ball one. Now a fly ball here and a routine chance for Stubbs out in center. And he's got it for out number one.
Now batting,
Didi Gregorius will try things again. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips.
Yeah, he got solid contact on that line out, but it just didn't work out. In this game, you have to trust your approach. Eventually, it's going to pay off.
Desmond is there to put it away for out number two. Wellington Castillo will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Into the seats, 0-1. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. 0-2 count. Here's the pitch. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Leading off the inning, Prince Fielder. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Well, it's a close ball game, but it's starting to get late. So they need to get at least one back here in this inning.
Ryan's ready. Here's the 0-1. Oh, and a big hack by Fielder, just like his daddy, but it's 0-2.
And on 0-2, I'd be shocked to see another fastball in the strike zone.
And he struck him out. The 10th victim set down on strikes thus far.
All right,
Shin-Soo Chu leans in, looking to replicate his last at-bat when he launched a solo home run.
Well, it was a two-strike breaking ball that he hit out of here, so we'll see if they go a different direction if they get him to two strikes again.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now.
And the way he's kept the ball around the plate so far, he deserves a few calls at this point in the game. Yeah, that's his second hit so far. He's got two of their four hits, so at least he's seeing the ball well.
Ian Desmond stands in as he looks at ball one here. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. 2012 was the breakout season for Ian Desmond despite some setbacks. After being named Nationals opening day shortstop, he made the All-Star team, although he didn't get to play due to an oblique injury that cost him some time. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame. So a pivotal moment here, and digging in now, Bruce Stubbs. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. Right by him here, and he's set up for another strikeout here. The count to 0-2. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. leading off the inning, Rob Refsnyder, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning.
Refsnyder.
He's set. Here it comes. Fly ball out toward left center field. Stubbs is in pursuit, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting.
Brett Gardner will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0 for 3 thus far.
Yeah, guys, not really providing the spark that they usually hope to get out of him. Maybe he can make something happen right here.
Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. Line drive to left. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Now batting.
Justin Turner will stand in. He flew out his last time up. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Skied into very shallow right. Chu is there, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Edgar Martinez will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, we take you back to inning number 6. This was his second home run of the ball game, as he'll stand in here looking for number 3. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. Now a move over to first, and he'll get back in safely.
Why not? Make him get dirty.
Oh, and he gets a hold of this one as it's in the air to deep left. Does he have another one? He does. It's another home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. His third home run of the ball game, and it's now 6-3.
Boy, have a night. His third home run of the ball game. I mean, he's absolutely brimming with confidence at the plate. Been a joy to watch so far.
Sam Dyson will enter the ball game out of the pen as he'll look to get the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Mark Teixeira will stand in now following the home run. And you wonder if that losing streak is about to go by the wayside.
Well, they're not home yet, but certainly this has been a much better performance than we've seen out of them for a while now. So all signs seem to be pointing to a potential victory.
And a breaking ball runs in and gets him, and I doubt there was any intent behind that.
Well, I know that instantly everyone's going to start pointing fingers out there, but when you're facing a guy like this, as a pitcher, you have to be allowed to work inside. That'll hurt a bit, but it's just part of the game you have to live with.
Carlos Beltran is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. He pulls this one into right. Chu will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. The Yankees get a couple on the two-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. New York leads it 6-3. Robinson Chirinos will lead things off here for the Rangers, to be followed by Elvis Andrus on deck. Hit hard down the line. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard.
The shortstop,
Elvis Andrus gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in 3 tries to this point. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory and taken in out there for the first out. Rougned Odor is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the third inning. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure. Oh, and look out as this runs in and gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one. First pitch coming. Here it is. Adrian Beltre is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. The hit-by-pitch count, definitely worth keeping an eye on there. Gardner over to his right. And that's the second out of the inning. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Mitch Moreland steps in for a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Oh, and he misses it. And this clangs off the wall near the 349 sign. And they'll get a little closer here as the run comes across to score from first. That makes it 6-5 now. Prince Fielder will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. But he can make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Tap foul at home plate. Trying to hold the lead. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Beltran on the run. He gets there to make the catch. And then striding in to start the ninth, Adam Jones, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning. Now time granted here at the plate as he'll step out of the box. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. And this is popped foul, but perhaps playable behind first. Under it is Fielder to put it away for the first down. Didi Gregorius stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0-for-3 in the game so far. Hard hit ball to second. Throw got him, and that's a gorgeous play.
The catcher, number 13.
Wellington Castillo is into the box now. He hit one over the wall back in the fifth. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. To first. Fielder has it. And he'll step on the bag himself. And the inning is over. Leading off the inning, Shin-Soo Chu, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. And this is high, a ball and a strike. And he should be okay to go the distance here. He's just now about to hit 100 pitches for the ball game. But this is gloved over there at first as he was in the right spot at the right time. One away.
Number 20,
Ian Desmond will dig in. Took a called third strike his last time. On the ground to the left side. Played on the backhand. On to first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out.
The center field, number 6.
Now at the plate, Drew Stubbs. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing and one.
Yeah, and you don't have to look much further than that location right there to see why he's been struggling. That pitch is right down the middle to start this at-bat.
High in the air and deep to straightaway left. Gardner going back, and he tracks it down. And this ball game is over.
Well, maybe.
A tight ball game all throughout. Winds up a slim one-run victory in the end as we get you one final look at our line score. And as we wrap things up here, what do you say we name this guy right here as the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award?
Yeah, really a game to remember for that man right there. He winds up finishing with three home runs. What surprised me was, after a while, why even pitch to him?
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB.
Welcome to our Wednesday edition of Inside the Show. Let's jump right into Tuesday's action. Starting in the AL East, the New York Yankees amassed 14 hits in the game as they beat the O's in Baltimore 5-3. They now have five straight wins. The Tampa Bay Rays cracked 14 hits overall as they got the best of the Dodgers at home 4-3. The Rangers got 11 overall hits as they beat the Blue Jays in Toronto 5-4. The White Sox knocked out 12 hits as a team as they beat the visiting Red Sox 2-1. The Indians combined to allow only 4 hits as they defeated the visiting Tigers 3-1. The Kansas City Royals combined to give up just 5 hits as they bested the visiting Nats 4-3.